Hi again, everyone. Chris Tisdell here again. In this presentation, I'm going to continue my series of videos on complex numbers. Now, in the previous presentation, we talked about factorizing complex polynomials. And in this video, I'm going to do another example illustrating how to use these kinds of ideas. So let me share my screen with you and we can get underway. All right, so this is what we looked at last time. I didn't prove any of these things, but the ideas were on the applications, okay? So suppose I've got a complex polynomial. The coefficients could be real. They could be complex. These 4 points are very important and very deep results. Every polynomial of degree n has at least one root in the complex numbers. That is, there is at least one number alpha such that p of alpha equals 0. If the coefficients, the ais, etc., are real, then the roots of the complex polynomials appear in conjugate pairs. If alpha is a root, then z minus alpha is a factor of the polynomial. That's like a factor theorem. And every polynomial of degree n can be factored into n linear parts. You can write it like this, where the ais are the alpha i's are the roots, and an is the coefficient of z to the n. Okay, so let's talk about an example now. Here we've defined a polynomial of degree 4. Show that 2i is a root of the polynomial. Illustrate that z squared minus 4 is a factor without division. And also find the other quadratic factor. Thus, factorize p of z into quadratic factors. Okay, we're not talking about linear factors there, just quadratic factors. Okay, so polynomials of degree 2. All right, so a is the easiest part. Okay, so let's just box our polynomial. A is the easiest part. All you need to do is put 2i into the polynomial for z, so I won't spend too much time on that. The important thing to remember is I squared equals negative 1. Okay, pretty much everything flows from there. Okay, if you expand these out, you'll get 0. Okay. All right. Now, what do we know then? We want to illustrate that z squared minus 4 is a factor without division. Well, part A tells us that z minus 2i is a factor of p of z. There we've, by the factor theorem, we've applied the factor theorem. Okay. And all the coefficients of the z's and the z squareds, etc., are real. So what does that mean? Well, it means that the conjugate of 2i is also a root. The coefficients of p are all real. We have z minus the conjugate is also a factor of p. So what's the conjugate of 2i? It's negative 2i. So it'll be z minus negative 2i. Okay, so we've got z minus 2i is a factor, z plus 2i is a factor. Remember, what we're trying to show is that z squared plus 4 is a factor. Well, the product of these two things will be a factor, and it turns out the product of these two things will be exactly that. Okay, so if I work this out by just expanding, I'll have z squared plus 4, again remembering that I squared equals negative 1. Okay, so that's part B. Quite happy about that. Also find the other quadratic factor. Okay, well now, we weren't allowed to use division up here, but we're allowed to use it now. So let's divide in and see if we can simplify here. Okay, so this is part B continued. So I'm going to divide z squared plus 4, which is z squared plus 0z plus 4, into my polynomial. Now, sometimes there are faster techniques, but this is the way that I'm just going to do it now. Okay, so that into that goes 2z squared times. So that times that, that times that, that times that gives you that. Take this away from that, and you'll get the following. Bring that one down. Okay, now divide this into this. You'll get negative 5z. And then that times that, that times that, that times that gives you the line down here. Okay, so this taken away from this gives you the following, and bring that negative 12 down, and finally this divides into that minus 3 times, and then this times this will give you actually the same as that. So that times that, that times that, that times that gives you the row. So you see those two rows are identical, so you get 0. Okay, so there's one quadratic factor, there's the other quadratic factor. So this is, yes, we're on to part C now. Okay. So there you go. All right, so you can go a little bit further. In here, there we factorize, the polynomial can be, says it can be factorized down to linear parts, okay? Where the a sub n is the coefficient of z to the n, and the ai's are all roots of p. Okay, so I want to leave you with something to do. So this is part D. This is an exercise for you. Okay. Show that P of Z has its linear factored form like this. Okay, this is Z minus 3. Okay, so this is a little exercise for you to do. You know that this is going to go to that, and it's really just a matter of splitting this up into this by finding the zeros of this, if you like, or using some other method. Okay, so that's an exercise for you to do. Okay, so that's my presentation. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you found it useful. If you have any suggestions, any comments, any feedback, anything at all, just post a comment or send me a message. I'd love to hear from you. Hope you're enjoying these videos. Please join me for the next few videos on complex numbers. Hope to see you then. Bye.